friends, let's solve problem on motion diagram. See, what is given in problem? A particle moves in a straight line with a velocity time diagram shown in figure. That means velocity time diagram is given. If s equal to minus 25 meters at t equal to 0, means initially position is minus 25 meters. Draw displacement time and acceleration time diagram for 0 to 24 seconds. What velocity time diagram is given? That one drawn here, next page, just see here. This VT diagram, what it represents? At 0 second, velocity is 0. Then at 10 second, velocity is 30 meters per second. Then at 16 second, velocity is minus 30 and remains constant. That means from 0 to 10 second, if we'll find out what is the slope of VT diagram, slope of VT diagram is constant and is positive. From 10 to 16 second, again inclined straight line, but velocity reduces, slope negative but constant, that means acceleration is negative. And from 16 to 24 second, velocity constant. From this one, nature of AT diagram, if we'll decide, so from 0 to 10 second, from 0 to 10 second, acceleration means slope of VT diagram, you will get positive. That means here I will write this acceleration is say A1. From 10 to 16 second, velocity decreases, slope constant, but slope is negative. That means this one is below T axis, acceleration A2. Velocity constant, that means here acceleration, its slope is what? 0. Now to find out A1, A2, we'll calculate what are the area under AT diagram is what change in velocity. Now here if we'll write area under this AT diagram, this area is say what? A1. This area is what? A2. Now area under AT diagram, A1 if we'll write here, this is a rectangle base into height. Here time is 0, here time is 10 second. Base of rectangle 10, height is A1. That means A1 is what? Area A1 is 10 into acceleration A1. The area A2 is negative, and this area again we will write with minus sign because it is below T axis. Base is 6, therefore base into height A2. That means from these areas, area under AT diagram represent change in velocity. Therefore, calculations for AT diagram, if we'll write here, A1 and A2 already are calculated. Calculations for AT diagram. For AT diagram, first time interval, if we'll take here, where for calculation of AT diagram, our formula remains same, delta V is area under AT diagram. Now this delta V for which time interval? So initially 0 to 10 second, first time interval 0 to 10 second. Now from 0 to 10 second, delta V equal to final V10, initial V0. Area under AT diagram, it is a rectangle, positive. That means this one is what? 10 A1. You know V10 unknown. V10 is given. Just check. Velocity at 10 second is 30. Velocity at 0 second is 0. Velocity at 10 second is known, which is 30. Velocity at 0 second is 0. Equal to 10 A1. That means acceleration A1 comes out to be 3 meters per second square. Similarly, next time interval if we'll take, now 10 to 16 second, again we'll write delta V, which one is velocity at 16 second minus velocity at 10 second equal to. Now what area under AT diagram you are getting here is negative, which one is below T axis, therefore base 6, height is A2. Velocity at 16 second, you know it is minus 16 second. And at 10 second, it is positive 30. Just check what is the velocity at 16 seconds and 10 seconds. Velocity at 16 seconds is minus 30. Velocity at 10 seconds is plus 30. That means here this is minus 30 and plus 30 equal to minus 6A2. Minus minus gets cancelled. This one minus 60. Minus 6A2. That means A2 comes out to be what? 10 meters per second square. Where it represents magnitude of acceleration, it is below t-axis, that means it is negative deceleration of particle. What is asking problem? Draw displacement time and acceleration time diagram. The acceleration time diagram we have drawn. Now we'll try for what? Displacement time diagram from 0 to 24 seconds. These accelerations we are getting here. Now from VT diagram, if you want to find out XT diagram, for that one, areas under VT diagram are important. To find out this area, again A1, A2 already written, I'll write here A3. This area is what? A4, right? This area is what? A5, and this area is A6. Now this time instant is important, because when we'll draw now XT diagram, for XT diagram what is important? Here velocity is positive, becomes 0 and then negative. At what time instant this velocity becomes 0? For this one, this height is 30 for this triangle. Again height is 30. It is same inclined straight line. That means you can say these angles are same. That means these two triangles are similar triangle. Height of this triangle is 30. Height of this triangle is also 30. That means it must bisect this 10 to 16. That means 6 seconds. That means this one point must be where? At 13 seconds. Now from this one, if we'll find out what is area, that is A3, A4, A5 and A6, we'll write first from 0 to 10, then 10 to 13, 13 to 16 and 16 to 24 seconds. We'll find out first one position. What you know at t equal to 0 second, position is not 0. Position is already given in problem. That position, what is given in problem is what? Minus 25 meters. It is given in problem initially. Next part, calculations for this XT diagram. Areas you have to find out carefully here. Calculations for XT diagram. For this one, one by one, if we'll find out, first basic formula is a change in position is area under velocity time diagram. Basic formula. Number one, first time interval 0 to 10 seconds. Delta x, if we'll write from 0 to 10 seconds, it becomes x at 10 seconds minus position at 0 seconds, right? Now area A1, if we'll write here, which one is a triangle, half of base into height, half of base of triangle is what? 10, and height of triangle is 30. Therefore, this area comes out to be 13 to 10, 300 divided by 2. That means this one is 150 meters. And x10 minus x0 already given as minus 25. Therefore, what we'll get here, position at 10 seconds equal to 125 meters. Position at 10 seconds. Next time interval, if we'll take, that is from 10 to 13 seconds. 10 to 13 seconds, if we'll write delta x. From 10 to 13 seconds, again, if we'll write for delta x, change in position is final, means x13 minus x10. Here what area you are getting is area of triangle. Area of triangle, so for this one half, base is 3 and height is 30. Now half of base into height, this area comes out to be 45 meters. What you are getting, x10 already calculated this is 125. Therefore, what position will get at 13 second is 45 plus 125. That means comes out to be 170 meters. Next position you are getting. Next time interval number 3. This is from 13 to 16 second. In 13 to 16 second delta x if you write. It is x, final means 16, initial means what? 13, x 16 minus x 13. Now area what we are getting here is negative because it is below t axis and this one is again half, base is 3, height is 30. That means area comes out to be minus 45. X 16 minus x 13 is 170. Therefore what x position at 16 second will get is again 125 meters. Number 4. Now this is from 16 to last time instant that is 24 second. If you want to write again change in position, it is final position minus initial position. Final is what? X 24 minus initial is what? X 16. Now this one is which area? So area under VT diagram from 16 to 24 second, which one is area of rectangle, but it is below T axis, that means what minus, its base is what 8 and height is what 30, therefore this area comes out to be 13 to 8 minus 240 meters. Here if we substitute value of x16, which one is minus here, x16 is what 125 equal to minus 240 meter, that means x of 24 means at 24 second, what will get here, minus what 240 plus 125, answer comes out to be minus 115 meters. Now as you are getting these are positions at various time instances, now if we'll draw here xt diagram, now we'll draw xt diagram, what is given, you know positions at all time instances. One more new location you are getting, that is 13 second, where at 30 second you are getting some position. Initial position what you know is minus 25 at t equal to 0 second and minus 115 at 24 second. Say I'll write here minus 115. Here what is given, minus 25. Maximum position we are getting at 13 second, this one is 170, and at 10 and 16 second what position we are getting is equal to 125, here also 125. Now how will join all the points? Say minus 25 to 125, then 125 to 170. First you check from 0 to 10 second, nature of VT diagram, velocity is increasing in which direction, positive direction, velocity increases in positive direction, that means slope of XT diagram must increase in positive direction, inclined straight line, that means nature of curve must be parabolic, number 1. Now from 10 to 13 second velocity is decreasing but in positive direction, slope of XT diagram must decrease in positive direction to represent such curve. From 13 to 16 second velocity is again increasing in negative direction because it is 0 and then minus 30, increasing in negative direction, slope of curve must increase in negative direction. Now what you are getting, horizontal straight line means here it is a constant, slope of next diagram must be constant, and constant you will get for inclined straight line. This magnitude of velocity is negative, means slope of this line what will represent now 16 to 24 second must be negative, which is possible for such inclined straight line. That means these three curves what we are getting here, this is number 1, what we are getting here, this is number 2, and what you will get here, this number 3, these three curves are parabolic. So this one completes your XT diagram. What is asking problem? draw VT diagram. VT diagram is given. Draw AT diagram. So A1, A2, you are getting accelerations. And in XT diagram, at various time instances, what is the position and what is the nature of this diagram? So what you are getting from 0 to 10, 10 to 13, and 13 to 16, curves are parabolic, and 16 to 24 seconds, it is inclined straight line. Thank you.